What's up? Welcome to another edition of At a Glance, the series in which I give you an appetizer sampler, a glimpse into a particular faction in 40K. And the goal behind it is to help you decide if you want to look further into the Force on your own, or maybe even start collecting that Force as well. So up on the chopping block this time by viewer request is the Revilers Loyalist Space Marine Chapter, a second founding successor, one of the few rare second founding successors, you could say, at least officially, of the Raven Guard, because they do descend from the Raven Guard. So that is the Revilers' whole shtick, is their Raven Guard successor to the Second Founding. So firstly, visuals. Visuals, very simple with a slightly complicated symbol. The armor is gray. It could be almost like a shadowy gray, almost like a blue tinge or a cool gray, but it's definitely this gray armor. I say kind of like a bluish cool gray because one of the old example models that GW had painted up, that's how their gray kind of looked. But in the artwork, their gray tends to be just straight up gray. So very mid-range gray. Silver chest emblem, white squad marking, yellow helmet lenses, black weapons. Their chapter symbol is a skull in profile with the eye of the skull, because he's looking at the side of the head, or side of that skull, so the eye is facing forward. And it's got a lightning bolt behind it, a yellow lightning bolt. You could probably find this as a third-party fan-made decal sheet to download and print on. What I would do is recommend you printing it on clear decal paper and then just painting the shoulder pad white and then neatly, carefully painting the gray around it once you have the decal sealed down on your shoulder pad. That would be my recommendation. But anyways, that's the look of the Revilers. It's a very simple color scheme. It's effective. It'll go quick with the exception of their symbol. And you can do some fun stuff with it in terms of weathering, battle damage, just general grime. They are a specialty in terms of stealth, so you can apply that to the armor a little bit as well. And generally, just have a fun time with it. So, as I mentioned, they're a successor of the Raven Guard from the Second Founding, which is a rare thing to have. Particularly, and I'm not going to go too deep because we don't have too much on these guys anyway, so I don't want to go too far down the rabbit hole on the few stuff we do, being an At a Glance and all. But their ranks were formed, you know, obviously post-heresy during the Second Founding, from the veterans slash survivors of the Drop Site Massacre. I'm not going to say exclusively, But the survivors of the Drop Site Massacre definitely went on to become the Revilers. I don't know if all of them. I don't know if there was enough to have more than what they had. I don't know if it's the case of whatever the survivors were, them plus other veterans made the Revilers. It's something along those lines. Basically, battle-hardened fighters of the Raven Guard went to be the Revilers. As a result, they have the Gene Seed quirks. They're going to have the pale skin and the black hair and everything. And also as a result, they have a special hatred for the Chaos Forces, the traitor forces present in the Drop Site Massacre that betrayed them. They carry that with them as their torch, basically, from their founding up until present time. That's a particularly a foe they want to take down. So any of the Chaos Forces present at the Drop Site Massacre, they take particular enjoyment and particular satisfaction of destroying and killing and everything. So that's their big thing. Their specialty is stealth, utilizing stealth again to position to make precise strikes before fading back, basically is what they do. Classic Raven Guard style setup, you could say. That's what they do. And with that, they like to bleed their foes dry, especially those Chaos Traitor Forces. And in fact, one of them was that they have credit of destroying most recently is a detachment of Alpha Legion. They bled dry in that manner. So they will strike countless times and fade back, death of a thousand cuts, basically. It's my understanding that against this Alpha Legion group, they basically bled and dry across like a star system for the fading battle of strike and fade back, which is particularly impressive against the Alpha Legion to bleed them dry that way. So definitely means they're masters of stealth. That's their specialty, those stealth precise hit and run style strikes. Also understanding their Raven Guard descent means they don't particularly have the most heavy armored equipment or terminal armor necessarily. So you gotta remember that kind of little streak that happened because of the Raven Guard and their Dropside Massacre. So that is kind of the Revilers thing. That's mostly what we know about them. They had one particular battle where they deployed with drop pods that were camouflaged, which I find kind of funny because you got this metallic thing hurtling through space, through the atmosphere, slamming into the ground, but it's camouflaged. I have to imagine it's camouflaged to make it hard to see where they landed after the dust settles and everything. Maybe so you don't see where they went and deployed from, or whatever the case is. I don't know, but it's an interesting little quirk that you could take with you if you wanted to. Camouflage drop pods. So they were also present at 13th Black Crusade. Now, time will tell how the Revilers fared past everything that has happened in the story of 40K thus far in the current lore. I say that because GW gave us the page on Warhammer Community called New Founding, the Ultima Founding. And with that, we have them talking about different foundings with Primaris Space Marines and all that, as well as how Primaris Space Marines are used to reinforce the particularly depleted chapters. What's also been talked about is the fact that some chapters are confirmed as destroyed or lost. This is interesting that they bring that up, because we've had some chapters on the cusp of being destroyed or not knowing if they're still around or not. It looks like in the next edition of 40K, we're going to get perhaps some straight-up confirmations on some chapters that we thought alive but are actually dead. Now, the Revilers didn't have anything particularly in the fluff to have them be worried about that, but they're also not one of the big names. GW specifically states none of the big ones were taken out. The Revilers aren't one of the big ones. I'm not saying that they have a high likelihood of being taken out, not at all, but is it theoretically possible because they're not one of the big ones and we have some chapters confirmed destroyed now? Yeah. So just keep that little grain of salt in the back of your mind. But if anything, the Revilers definitely are going to be one of every other chapter out there that you could put some Primaris support and reinforcement in if you wanted to. Now, I think they'll survive, but you never know. There could always be something out of left field. So with that said, what codex, what rulebook is best to use to represent the Revilers? Well, and the limited run we have left of 7th edition, it will be the Space Marine Codex. That Space Marine Codex. When we get into the beginnings of the next edition of 40K, because everything is incompatible from the previous editions, it's going to be one of the Imperium books. Now, I don't know which Imperium book is going to represent the Space Marine stuff in it. I don't know if one will have Space Marines and Space Wolves, and the other one will have Blood Angels and Dark Angels, amongst other stuff. I don't know. Whatever Imperial Index book has the regular Space Marine stuff, slash Chapter Tactics, whatever the case may be, of the Raven Guard, that is the book to use there. And then, of course, once we start getting the codices again, assuming we're looking at a standard regular Space Marine codex to be kind of like how it is now, that would be the codex to use whenever that happens in the future. So, kind of a wordy thing to say here, but we're in a weird kind of situation with codices and all that. It'll boil down to, at the end of the day, assuming the future edition codex for Space Marines functions and is laid out similar to the one we have now in terms of what chapters represent and all that, that will still be the codex to use. I don't know what's going to happen with supplemental books or how those are going to be handled in the next edition. There was a Raven Guard one, if I recall, but considering the next edition is so close, I wouldn't worry about getting that or the current codex, to be honest with you. But definitely the current the Space Marine Codex, if it stays the way it is going to be the way to represent Raven Guard. And by stay the way it is, I mean in terms of having the chapters in there that they have. So, yeah, it's a lot of talking on what would best represent them, but I think you get the idea. Now, it comes to collecting the revilers, any generic bits and kits from Forgeworld and GW for Space Marines, and maybe even some Chaos Space Marine bits, depending upon if you like a certain, like, you can file off the Chaos icons and you have a bandolier weapon of ammunition or whatnot, which could kind of fit with their stealth, guerrilla-esque precision strike specialty, if you will. But any of the generic bits and kits from Forgeworld and GW for regular Space Marines will work. Primaris stuff is scaled differently and it's not going to work. But, you know, that's to be expected. I mean, it'll work with itself, but it's not going to work for just randomly bit bashing stuff together outside of shoulder pads and helmets. I wouldn't really recommend looking at any of the Raven Guard stuff. They didn't have the Raven Guard symbol everywhere. But anything from Horus Heresy period through to the 41st millennium from Forgeworld and GW that's generic will work fine for the revilers. When it comes to painting them, you could have some fun in doing some dry brushing techniques for multiple gray layers and smoothing it out and then wash and then trying to get it to be a nice gradient of gray. You could even try and do kind of a cooler, almost blue-tinged gray if that's what you're trying to go for. As long as it's gray armor, you'll be good. And the armor itself will go pretty quick in that regard. It's going to be their symbol that'll give you the most problems in terms of the scheme. Their white squad marking is standard. That'll be pretty easy to get, no problem. Anyways, that's really it for the revilers. An interesting chapter. Their fluff is really tiny. It honestly is a bit of a stretch to do them. But given their history of their founding, it made it work because they have a special hatred for the traitor forces from the Dropside Massacre. So you can imagine their specialty of stealth and striking from the shadows and bleeding a foe dry gets heightened to an extra level against those particular forces. So anyways, with that said, that's the Revilers Space Marine chapter. I think they're cool. They definitely have a lot of plot potential in their founding. If you kind of attribute that throughout their time period, throughout the 40K timeline to the 41st millennium, if you just stick with that veterans and survivors of the Rousside Massacre mentality and have that just kind of ground into the being of the Astartes of this chapter throughout the millennia, you have some pretty hard and gruff stealth soldiers. So that's kind of cool. Anyways, that's it. So thanks for sticking through it. Any questions, comments, or requests, leave them in the comment section. And until next time, take it easy.